Hey, what's going on again, everybody? You know, we have not had much in the way of HBCU sports this year, obviously, but we have had a lot of lists, especially this week. We had the Black College Football Hall of Fame, which had a nice swag flavor to it. And then on Friday, the MEAC came out with its all-time MEAC football team, as voted on by the fans, because who wants that smoke? Just pass it off to the fans. So I'm going to pass it off to our Stephen J. Gaither, who loves to smoke any day of the week. He's going to tell you who's in, who's out, and who got snubbed on the week of list.
Yeah, Tally. So like you said, the list came out on Friday. And before we talk about the list, we got to acknowledge the fact that the fans were the ones who made this list. So they got a chance to get out and vote and talk about who they thought was the best of the 50 years of the MEAC. And so this is a tough thing to slide 50 years of football in and only put 50 players in. So some of the guys that are on there, Antoine Bethea, a Pro Bowl safety for a long time in the NFL. We've got Tariq Cohen, of course, the all-time leading rusher of the MEAC. You got Robert Porche, who was a beast in the NFL but started his career at South Carolina State. You've got guys like Jaquay Nunley, who ended his career as college football's all-time leading receiver. And so there are a lot of great players on there. The list is up on HBCUGameDay.com, so you guys go check it out. But with any list, you talk about the guys who are on there, but there's also the guys who are not there, right? Who are some of the guys that were not on this list that should be there? And so as I've been seeing the talk around, I have my list, but I wanted to address something else really quick. I see a lot of folks questioning why certain guys who are Hall of Fame, Pro Bowl or Pro Football Hall of Famers, or should be Pro Football Hall of Famers, guys like Willie Lanier, who played at Morgan State, Ken Riley, who was a great defensive back and later a coach, who played at FAMU, Elvin Bethea at North Carolina A&T, why those guys are not on the list. And the reason that those guys are not on the list is because the MEAC did not exist then. The MEAC is actually the baby of the four HBCU leagues in the NCAA. It wasn't formed until 1971. So a lot of those great players that we talk about historically played their college football in either the CIAA or the SIC. So I think we definitely need to acknowledge that. So there's some great names that are not there, but they actually should not be on the list because they didn't play in the MEAC, even though they've been using them on their Pro Football Hall of Fame list. But that's another story. But I want to talk about some of the guys that I thought should be on the list. You know, I've only been able to see the last 15 years or so of MEAC football history. But I would say a guy like Lamar Renard, how do you not have him on this list? He went 35-2 as a starter. He won back-to-back MEAC championships as a starter. They had an unbeaten season with him as a starter. He won two Celebration Bowls, and he was just a great player for that two-three year period, and really helped carry them when everybody thought that after Tariq Cohen was gone, they would be history. So we have to talk about that. And then we also have to talk about a guy like we got to talk about FAMU. There are no quarterbacks from the Gulf Coast era that are on the MEAC's list. You look at Patrick Bonner. Now, he only played 1 year at Florida A&M, so maybe you say that's why he doesn't get in, but, I mean, he was, like, the national player of the year in a lot of instances. Yeah, so you've got him. Then you got Juwan Sider, who was offensive player of the year in the MEAC and led the team to the NCAA Final Four, to the national semifinals. And he's not on here either. But I think out of all the Gulf Coast quarterbacks, there's Quinn Gray. He's not on the list. Like, Quinn Gray, he stuck around through all of those guys. And then once he got the chance to have the reins to himself in 2000 and 2001, he just did great things. He led them to the MEAC title, back to the playoffs. And he had a great career and went on to play in the NFL as well. He's not on this list. I don't get it. You can also look at the receiver position. I think there are guys like Elijah Bell, who just played at North Carolina A&T, who had a very successful career there. But I think even a bigger case is Kanan Lamb from FAMU, who played alongside Nunley, who played with some of those great receivers and still is one of the top all-time leading receivers in MEAC history as well, despite having to play with those guys. So those are just a couple of the guys that I felt like immediately jumped off of me. I probably could think of more if I thought about it a little bit, but I'd like to hear from the rest of the folks as well. So let us know in the comments who you think from the MEAC era should have been on that list and it wasn't on that list. So yeah, that's again, 50 years into 50 players in football, in any sport, but especially football is very tough. So shout out to everybody who voted and let us know what you guys think.